So to kick us off, what is CUI?
Tell us.
Man, CUI is a little wild. So before we get into the definition, I wanted to show a little in the beginning slide. So the reason we're all here today is because of this beautiful executive order that was signed by President Obama in 2010, establishing the controlled unclassified information.
Could you call this the genesis of CUI?
You could call genesis of CUI, at least the CUI we know and love today. So we're all here because this kind of domino effect that's been playing out in different agencies that we work with, right? DOD, Department of Homeland Security, all of those different agencies out there. So let's start with the definition. You've probably seen this before. You've probably seen a lot of it, to be honest with you. CUI is government created or owned information that requires safeguarding or dissemination controls consistent with applicable laws, regulations, and government-wide policies. Everything is not CUI. I think we need to say that to the bleachers in the back. Everything is not CUI. Misconception there, and our good friend Ryan Bonner had a LinkedIn post about this the other day, that, you know, it's actually more expensive to deploy NIST 800-171 simply because people are doing it on systems that don't even have CUI, not part of their boundary, right? So it's very important to understand the basis of what this comes from. It has to have an applicable law, regulation, or government-wide policy. And we're going to talk about that in more detail and how you can find out if it applies to you. Make sure, this is one of my favorite slides, make sure to CYA with your CUI. So what's really good to know about that is just as it reads, right? Talk to the information owner. This is straight out of a DOD handbook that's for public release. And they state this, whether you're a sub of a sub of a sub, a prime, working directly with the DOD, make sure that you are having good, consistent communication on the type of information you should be receiving on behalf of this contract and what the deliverables, if they are going to be CUI, what kind of CUI they're going to be, right? Because you have to, again, prepare all of this documentation and understanding around it. So really, really important. If you're a small business, designate someone the CUI czar that's charged with interfacing with the different organizations that you're getting flow downs from with your DFARS clause.
If you don't know what CUI is, much like CUI, you need to ask your contracting officer there.
That's right. Yeah. You need to CYA with CUI because that's exactly what the DOD is doing and it's exactly what your prime's doing. So you don't want to be on the bottom of that pile. So next up, good to know, CUI is not just related to the Department of Defense, even though we feel the most kind of stringent controls around CUI through them. These are a lot of other agencies that deal with it too. They create it. They could distribute it as part of their contracts. And every agency has their own requirements or should have their own requirements in handling that information. So you can see a lot of great logos up there, right? A lot of agencies that you probably collaborate with or do work for, whether it's kind of on site or supplying different parts and things of that nature. Just know that things are changing in this environment. Jacob Horn points this out quite a bit, where these regulations, these requirements for enhanced cybersecurity is growing across the whole federal base. So really make sure to be in constant contact and understanding with your contracts manager and with your BD team to see what they're seeing on the requirement side, because you might need a very stringent requirement or an environment built to handle that data.
And at Summit 7, we're actually seeing a lot of agencies outside of the DOD adopt NIST 800-171 and a lot of policies dealing with CUI.
Yep.
For obvious reasons. So it expands a lot of different agencies here. So it's growing.
It's growing rapidly. So who is in charge? This is always a fun question that I get asked. Like, who's doing this thing? Who's running the ship, right? It's like, well, let's walk through that. So National Archives, you might be familiar with them, responsible for maintaining CUI categories. So they're the ultimate source of truth on defining not only the categories that fall underneath that, but also the safeguarding and dissemination references on reinforcing why it's CUI or why it might be CUI to you. Next up, NIST, one of our favorite four-letter words, National Institute of Standards and Technology, responsible for determining the controls needed to implement the protection of CUI, right? So they have the baselining of handling that information. They hold the controls. NIST is not a compliance standard. NIST 800-171 is a control set, right? So when people say, I want to be NIST compliant, we have to kind of unpack where they're actually getting the compliance requirements from, right? Usually contract clauses and things of that nature. Last but not least, one of our favorites, federal agencies. I put the DoD logo up here because, again, they're the one applying the most pressure these days. They're responsible for enforcing these requirements on contracts and flowdowns and things of that nature. So we have the people that define it. We got the National Archives, the people that tell you how to protect it. That's NIST. And then the federal agencies that kind of wrap all that up together are charged with enforcing that. And then if needed, they can add additional requirements above and beyond just the beautiful NIST 800-171 controls.